So I got up this morning before we went to this festival, and I was woken up by Colin.
What? I don't know what you're talking about.
You know exactly what I'm talking about.
I'm gonna go get some.
He comes in the room, right? I didn't even know he had a camera on. He's just like, "Hey, buddy, how's it going?" I'm like, apparently I'm a heavy sleeper.
Okay.
And I really didn't even know you had a camera on me though. Like I swear to God, I looked up and it was almost like you hit it or something, like under your man boob or something. You're a dick, by the way.
You start with a whiskey shot just to feel warm, but it's not quite enough, so you have yourself two more. You hear a song and sing along, and it fills your heart with cheer, so you grab yourself another shot and a frothy pint of beer. You start with a whiskey shot just to feel warm, but it's not quite enough, so you have yourself two more. You hear a song and sing along, and it fills your heart with cheer, so you grab yourself another shot and a frothy pint of beer.
So we're going to the Beer, Bacon, and Music Festival down in the Great Frederick Fairgrounds, right down the road from here. We actually tried to get in last year, but we just weren't able to do it, but this year they've been nice enough to grant us press passes, so we're going to go check that out. They're promising a lot of craft brews, they're promising a lot of bacon, and they're promising some really good music, so I'm really looking forward to this.
You start your day off right here.
Yeah, try that.
That's why it's up front.
So first on deck, we try some Weyerbacher. Weyerbacher's got some really good beers, and we get to try their Sunday Morning Stout. And this stuff has got an ABV of 11.3.
All right,
yep.
Let me get a look at that.
Very chocolate looking head.
Yeah.
Yeah, wow.
I haven't tried it yet.
Like, all I taste on the initial sip, despite it being actually a really good beer, is alcohol. Like, I felt like I had just taken a shot of whiskey or something. It was pretty potent. And if that's any indication of how the rest of the day was gonna go, so, the next beer that we try is from a company known as The Raven. It's called Annabelle Lee. It's got an ABV of about 4.5, and it's a wit beer. It's a Hefeweizen. Now, particularly, I love Hefeweizen. It's some of my favorite beer. If you've ever had a Hoegaarden and you hated it, chances are we're not friends. No, that's kind of dickish to say, I guess. Don't you think? But, you know.
You don't like the beer I like? Screw you!
It's myrrh.
Myrrh! Drink my beer! Ass!
Ironically enough, this is much better of a morning, because we're there at like, what, 9, 10 in the freaking morning?
11.
11. We're at there, thank you. We're there at 11 in the morning, and this is a much more suitable morning beer than the previous one was. That's not to say that the Sunday Morning Stout was bad or anything, but if I were to get up in the morning on a weekend and want a shower and a beer, I'm probably gonna go with the Hefeweizen. Just saying.
All right, so we've got a
51 rye India Pale Ale.
All right, so we got a Monument India Pale Ale.
51 rye India Pale Ale.
So we get to a point. I'm only two beers in, and already I'm starting to slur my speech. Thanks, by the way. Sunday Morning Stout, but we get to Monument City Brewing, and they have a beer called 51 Rye, and appearance, pours a murky amber color. The head is a finger high and white in shade. The tension isn't particularly hot, though a consistent texture is kept. If I remember correctly, it does have a taste of rye bread and a little bit of like an orange taste as well. It wasn't bad. Not the most memorable beer of the day, though. What can I say? All right, so I'm about three beers in at this point, and I'm wanting some charred dead flesh inside of my mouth. So, okay, they've got about like four different types of bacon here. You know, you got your regular, you got your applewood cut, you got your salt and pepper, then you got your jalapeno. And the jalapeno sneaks up on you. Like, it gets in your mouth, and you think, oh, it's bacon. I like that. It's a nice texture. I like that. I like pig flesh. And then all of a sudden, your mouth's on fire. And this is really sneaky because it makes you go out and need more beer. It's a pervasive cycle. I like this. Good thinking. Good thinking.
All right, so first and foremost, just from like my vantage point, Colin's not only got a camera here, he's also got a GoPro right here, so I'm kind of hitting both at the same time. Have fun editing that, by the way. So, it looks interesting. So it's like boom, 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 boom. Anyway, so for at Trogues, I got the what's defined only as the Grouch.
Now, beer der Grouch.
The beer der Grouch. I sound drunk, I'm not.
Yet?
Maybe a little bit, I don't know. I need my mommy. Anyways, let's try this out.
Oh, that's good.
I like that.
So, we tried this beer from Dewclaw, and for the life of me, I just can't get the fucking pronunciation. I still can't get the pronunciation of this right. Umbashi Gosh.
Yes.
Now, apparently the Gosh is actually a style of brewing, which is actually, and it's an unfiltered wheat beer made with 50 to 60% malted wheat, which creates a cloudy yellow color and provides a refreshing crispness and twang.
All right, so we just went by our good friends at Duplai, and we got some Gosh. Some Gosh.
Umbashi Gosh.
I don't know how to pronounce that. Success! It tastes great! Let's go!
I had no idea that you could really, like, that was breaking a law. Like, is it still in play? Is it kind of like you can't walk down in Florida with an alligator tethered to you, like... Umbashi Gosh, it's a beer to change your life. It's good. It's good to put in a glass and walk around in. It's good stuff. So about this point during the shoot, I had just gotten drunk. So yeah, kind of got a little too close to the camera.
Our friends at Old Dominion just hooked us up with some hop lips, as in like hop lips Houlihan. We just totally sang the match theme, by the way. By the way, I think part of the fun of this whole like video series is just seeing me at the beginning of the video, like I'm perfectly normal, and then just seeing me degenerate into drunken madness. Cheers.
If you look at the footage, I actually made contact with camera, and you should have seen the look on Colin's face. He was just like, what are you doing, drunken asshole?
At first I was worried, but then I realized, oh wait, it's his camera. If he breaks it, it's on his fucking ass.
That is true. Yeah, I spent, what is it, like $300 on that fucking camera, so. So we go to Old Dominion, and we try this beer called Hop Lips, which is an American IPA. I so try not to say Houlihan there, by the way. I'm a huge MASH fan, but this is a really good beer. It's about 6.0 ABV. It's nothing typically special. Apparently it's a seasonal beer, so if you want to try and get that. All these beers typically are for sale around the Maryland region, so if you see anything like that and you want to try it out, do it. I like hoppy beers. I'm really weird in that. Like, I like both Hefeweizen and I also like IPA. And at the same time, like, I don't know, like for instance, every once in a while, I just want some regular old piss water. What can I say? IPA. It's just simple and to the point. But IPAs, in particular, you tend to find a lot of IPAs at beer festivals, and a lot of them are just kind of the same. This one kind of fits in that category, but I definitely would recommend it just because it's a little more like a lager too, and I really liked it. And it's not too heavy on hops. Funny enough, one of the bands playing at this festival was a friend of the podcast, somebody I've known for a little while, but definitely Colin's known a lot longer, Adrienne. And she's a really talented musician. We've seen her play with another band in the past, but today she's playing with Adrienne Smith and some guy named Matt. And that's not me just not knowing what the band name is. That's the name of the band. It's Adrienne Smith and some guy named Matt. I like it. I like it. It's bare bones, but it's to the point. I like her voice, man. I think she's got a really good voice. She's got this kind of, like, almost Adele-like voice. It's very, like, you know, deep.
Sultry.
It's sultry, but it's also, like, not like, you know, because obviously, you know, she's a woman. So she doesn't have, like, a deep voice like this or anything, or like Pavarotti, but she's got that, like, kind of deeper, smoky sound to her, which really works for her blues. She does a lot of blues, and I really liked it. One of the things we gotta mention too is that this was the weekend after B.B. King died, and she did a fantastic tribute to him, and I thought it was just really well done. So good on you, Adrian. I liked it. I really liked it. Dug it. And here's to you, B.B. Sweet, crispity Jesus, man. This funnel cake. It's like it was descended from heaven, bestowed upon me from the gods. It was so good. Like, I couldn't eat it all. It just, oh my god, it was so big. I couldn't fit it all in my mouth. That's horrible. But seriously though. It was freaking amazing. There was like chunks of bacon like this freaking, well, that like that freaking big in there. It was just coated in maple syrup, and just had all kinds of like, and of course, in typical funnel cake fashion, it had enough white powder on there that people thought you had a cocaine problem afterwards. Really damn good. You know, and I got me a nice, tall, cool lemonade to go with it, and because screw it, I needed to hydrate after that, man. Like, I had been drinking so much beer that I was like, you know what? I need to step away from beer for a second. So, overall, I really liked this festival, man. There was a lot of really good stuff there, a lot of really good breweries, there was a lot of bacon. There were only four types of bacon if you paid for the ticket, for free basically, or for the price of the admission. If you wanted to try something a little more crazy, like, you know, chocolate dipped bacon, or bacon leaves, or
Bacon jam,
thank you. Or one of my favorite things, which was the funnel cake maple syrup bacon. Goddamn, that was good. you know, you had to pay extra for that. Well, it was worth the price of admission. They had a taco truck there too, man. Freaking love me some taco trucks. I think I'm gonna cover some taco truck stuff on here one day, because there's nothing quite like a good taco truck, in my opinion. But overall, yeah, man, this was a really good festival. There was a lot of music, a lot of beer, a lot of bacon. Lived up to its name. I'm a fan. I'll be back next year. Thank you. Hey, what's up? So if you like the show, feel free to subscribe for more. We're definitely going to have more episodes coming out here soon. And feel free to check out castwavestudios.com for much more content. Also, feel free to check me out on Twitter at bmassey1987. Also, I'm on Vine, Orange Hat Man. Look for the orange hat. I've got all kinds of other videos coming out here soon. Stay tuned. It's going to be a great year.